no member can be here. But we need to teach our children the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after the death of his son Ibrahim, the sun eclipsed. So many people, large number of them, said, so the sun eclipsed for the sake of Ibrahim. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave the lecture to all of them and wanted to teach them that the sun and the moon, they are two signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said this in the hadith, Al-Shamsu wal-Qamar ayatayni min ayatillah. No one can control the sun or the moon. Both of them are signs of the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he said, La yunkasifani limawti ahadin wala lihayati. They are not eclipsed on account of anyone's death, and they are not eclipsed on account on anyone for anyone's birth. And the Prophet said, فَإِذَا رَأَوْتُهُ رَأَيْتُمُوهُ إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُ الْخُسُوفِ إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُ الْخُسُوفِ. If you see khusuf for the qamar and khusuf for the shams, say, come to the salah and say subhanallah, alhamdulillah, and rush to remember Allah and make dua for him. And also give charity. This is the etiquette of the khusuf, the lunar eclipse. And subhanallah, this surah that we recited, Surah Al-Qiyamah, the last surah, Allah says, وَخَسَفَ الْقَمَرِ. By the day of judgment, one of the signs of the day of judgment, the khusuf, the lunar eclipse. Allah said that, وَخَسَفَ الْقَمَرِ, the moon eclipse in the day of judgment. So subhanAllah, what you will see after a short time, after half hour, it is just exactly one of the signs of the day of judgment that you will see. Before the day of judgment, directly, the sun will eclipse, the moon will eclipse, and subhanAllah, then the rest of the signs of the day of judgment will take place. So please, put in your consideration that when you have a relationship with Allah, put in yourself that you are doing that worship to save yourself from the hellfire. And also there is something important for the sun and the moon. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, they cannot be controlled by anyone. No one controls sun, no one controls the moon. And let me give the advice also for our sisters in the back. We have, and I'm sorry to say that, but I have to invest the chance, the opportunity to take some of the teachings of Rasulullah. Some people believe that someone read their hand and told them about what will happen in the future. Subhanallah, we cannot now control the moon. After half hour, you will not see the moon, the light of the moon. Allah said in Surah Al-Qasas, قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمُ اللَّيْلَ سَرْمَدًا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامِ مَنْ إِلَهٌ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ يَأْتِيكُمْ بِلَيْلٍ تَسْكُنُونَ فِيهِ. Have you considered if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took that light from the moon for eternity, who will give you that light back? Who can control the sun? Who can control the moon? Sometimes, nowadays, till now, we still have some of this disease. You know, people went to the moon, people went to the space, and still, till now, we believe in the rain. We believe in a blue eye. We believe in hijab. That hijab can make us good. On someone do some kinds like magic to save us. And some people, till now, they may have contact with people back home. They know magic, they know so and so, and wallahi, it is signs of kufr, disbelieving in Allah. Allah said, the sun and the moon, no one can control, and no one can control your destiny. But subhanAllah, we have people till now, they love to play with the shaitan. They love to go with the way of the shaitan. They love to hurt others. Be aware of this. Wallahi, it is called dhulm. When you oppress somebody by trying to hurt them like this, wallahi, you will not die before you see something bad in yourself, in your family members, because you used to oppress others. So brothers and sisters, think about if after this lunar eclipse, we will have the day of judgment. What you will do, how you will react. So let's, by the time, you know what? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I'm gonna finish with this. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, subhanAllah, explained our situation. Most of people, by the time of the lunar eclipse, they go with their cell phones to take pictures, and please give me selfie with the lunar eclipse. Give me so. You know Rasulullah said, do what? Did what? By the time of the eclipse, he cried, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He remembered the day of judgment. And he said, لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ لَأَعْلَمُ. If you knew what I know, لَبَكَيْتُمْ كَثِيرًا. You will weep much, and you will laugh little. This is the reality. So by the time of lunar eclipse, you have to remember your major sins and the minor sins. You have to remember that you will go back to Allah. You have to remember the day of judgment. When it takes place, when it happens, everything will be exposed. Everything will be shown to everybody. It is called Yawmul Ard. Yawmul Ard. This is the day that Allah will show everything to everybody. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins, the minor sins and the major sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us from the hellfire. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower all of us with His mercy. Jazakumullahu khaira for applying the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah will be proud of you by the day of judgment, inshallah. Jazakumullahu khaira. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.